minute 90 something, we always speak about a bit of luck, a bit of a star behind us, but I think the reality is that we deserve, because especially in the second half we were so dominant, we were so intense in our rhythm, in our attacking wave, that I always believe that sooner or later the goal would arrive. But I have to say that Hull City did an amazing job. They defended with everything. They couldn't counter-attack because I think we played very well defensively. Every time we lost the ball, we were really, really strong. But I think they did fantastically well. Congratulations also to them. And if I was the chairman, I would give immediately the job to Mike Phelan, because it's in the eyes of everyone that the players are giving everything, the players are with him, the players, they cannot do more than what they did. So congratulations to Mike and to the Hull boys.
Absolutely. I imagine every single Hull fan will repeat what you think about Mike Phelan. Marcus Rashford, he's had to wait for his chance, hasn't he? I'm sure he was wondering when it would come, and when it did come, he took it. What will be your words to him when you get back into the dressing room?
Well, a big smile and a big hug, and I think he's enough. He's working extremely well. And both times when the team was in trouble and needing one goal, Community Shield with the result 1-1, and yet today with the 0-0, he came on and he gave a special contribution. And everybody's speaking about him or Ibra. They can play together, like we showed today. I think even eventually, with more work, he can play coming from one of the sides. But I think the kid is a striker, and when we play with him and Ibra together, we give different problems to the opposition. Sometimes Ibra drops back because he always like to play with the ball on his feet. The kid is faster, has penetration, has appetite to attack the last line. So we tried everything. I was thinking about a last change with Marwan out, but I was a bit afraid of them in the set pieces, and I know how this sometimes happens. You dominate, they go there in one set piece in the last minute, and you lose the game. And Marwan is a special guy for us in the defensive work, but I think everyone, they played well, they gave everything, and especially this kind of a spirit which is, I think, amazing, because you only win these matches if you want to win a lot. If you are in a comfortable situation and you think a point is not bad, or let's see what's going to happen, normally you don't win. But the boys, till the last minutes, they believe. And of course, I feel sorry for all, because they couldn't do more to get a point. But I think my guys deserve, and I think the way the fans supported them, especially in the second half, I think also the fans, they had that feeling that we were giving everything.
Jose, it's Rio here. How you doing? I know it's hard on your heart, but in the last 5 minutes there, we was all up here saying, oh, listen, at least they're going for it. Even if it's 0-0, they're going for it. The last couple of years, we haven't seen that. We've been frustrated sitting there watching the studios and the fans at home. How do you, as a manager, instill that in your team to keep going in them last 5 minutes?
We start thinking about what this game could be even before the game starts, because we know the way they defend. We know that today they wouldn't play Edelston more in front. They would play with Edelston in a line of three with Myler and Klukas. The wingers, they defend all the time. So we knew that we were going to find a very organized wall. And tactically, you can change things. You can bring different situations to the game. You can try to create new problems to your opponent. But it's the mental side of it that can make a difference. And we speak about this all the time. We speak about our objective is only one, is to be champions. If in the end of the season we finish second, third or fourth, it's because somebody was better than us. If we finish fifth or sixth, it's because we were not good enough. But we have to play to win every game. If we don't win, we don't win. And of course we know that we are not going to win, but the mentality is there. The boys are giving everything. For me, it's amazing when I look to my side and I see the people on the bench suffering with us and jumping with the goal. We have a really strong group. It's a privilege for me to work with these guys.
Well, you can now catch your breath, you can go home, maybe go house hunting over the next couple of weeks if you want, because it's the international break. But when you sit down and you assess what's happened so far in the first three Premier League games, how do you reflect on your start at the club?
I think we changed the team, we changed the dynamic, we changed the way we think football, but also the way we think the competitions, and also the way we think the day by day in the club. I know Mr. Van Gaal so well because we work together, and we are so different in almost every aspect of our job. And sometimes you arrive in a club, and if the players are not so open for the change, it's more difficult. The players were open. The players were waiting for me. I can say that way. They were waiting to give everything. And I think we play a different football. I think when the ball goes to a fullback, you see what we do this season and what they did before. And this is just an example. I think in many matches, the fullbacks are the first players to receive the building up pass, and then is the trigger. And what you do with the trigger? You play the ball back to the central defender, or you start trying to find lines to attack the last line. That's what we are trying to do. Defensively, we don't play man-to-man. We play zonal. I think the players are growing up a lot because they feel much more comfortable that way. And I'm really, really happy. I'm really happy with the evolution of the team. And I think we can obviously do much, much better because the players are very good. My solutions on the bench are very good. Today, I was looking to the bench and I was counting the solutions, and all of them good solutions. And I kept Ashley Young on the bench, and I kept Memphis Depay at home. And you know, the solutions are really good. The squad is much better than what they showed last season. Of course, we bought, and I think we bought well. The players are better than what they showed last season. So I think we are in a good direction. We are not going to be consistent. I think we are going to be a little bit down, up in some moments, because it's part of the evolution of the team. But I trust the guys a lot, and my feeling is that they also trust me.
And so, if you're happy with your strength and depth, no more business before 11 o'clock on Wednesday night?
No.
You're done.
No business. I want to keep every player. I want to go to the Europa League with a good squad. Imagine I go to Europa League and I change the four defenders, and I play Damian, Phil Jones, Smalling and Marcos Rojo, and I rest four players and I play with four new. Or I rest Ibra, Mata and Martial, and I play Mkhitaryan, Marcus Rashford and Ashley Young. So I have a very good squad. I'm really happy with what I have in my hands, and I repeat, it's a privilege for me to work with the boys.
Good man. So you can put your feet up on Wednesday night, and up next for you, the small matter of your first Manchester derby.
You are right, yeah.
Enjoy that one. Thanks
Bye.
For joining
Bye.
Us, Jose.
See you guys.
Enjoy
See
the break.
You.
Thank
Bye.
You. Take care.
Jose, they used to call it Fergie time when United scored in stoppage time. Did you enjoy your first taste of that, if you like, as United manager?
I'm happy that for many, 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 many years, many United fans still call it Fergie time. I'm more than happy with that. Such a legend in the club. I'm more than happy to say that we won at Fergie time. I'm more than happy with that.
Did you at any point think this is just not going to happen for us?
No, until the last second. Because if we win, it's not a miracle. It's just a consequence of what we were doing on the pitch. We finished the game with Valencia and Luke Shaw playing as wingers. We played with Rooney and Mkhitaryan in the inside. We played with Zlatan and Marcus Rashford, strikers. We play with Paul behind these two lines. So we went with everything. We put everything, every ammunition on the pitch, and the intensity and the rhythm of the game and the creation of chances and the diversity of the football we were playing. We should score before. We had chances to score before, but I have also to say that a Man United man like Mike Phelan organized these his wall in an amazing way with a fantastic spirit, trying everything to stop us, and they were almost successful on that.
You've got such a strong squad, you can bring on substitutes who make a genuine impact, and this is what we saw, I guess, today.
It's the squad. Then I have to make decisions, but the squad is there. The squad is there waiting for me with lots of solutions, and they are working so well during the week that I trust that they are ready to come and to give an important contribution. So yes, of course, I'm really happy.
What we've seen today shows why the Premier League is so watched around the world. One team attacking, one team defending, pouring with rain, last minute winner, crazy game.
And could happen they win. They went there with a shot, deflection, De Gea goes to one side, the ball goes to corner. If the ball goes in, they win. But I think we shouldn't be afraid of this. We want to win matches, we have to take our risks. And today we got to two amazing points in the last couple of minutes.
Well, thanks very much for that. Thank you very much. Cheers.